My great hope and prayer is that in time to come, the Aga Khan University will be on the frontiers of scientific and humanistic knowledge, radiating intelligence and confidence, research and graduates into flourishing economies and progressive legal and political systems.
It started with a bold and far-reaching vision. Our founder and chancellor, His Highness the Aga Khan, saw that universities deliver knowledge, innovations, and leaders that change the world.
More than perhaps any other contemporary type of institution, universities can provide a forum in which a creative, inquiring, and logical approach can be made to the significant issues of the time.
So our founder set out to build a new university for the developing world, one dedicated to improving the quality of life of people, regardless of origin, faith, or gender. As we celebrate our inaugural Founders' Day and mark the 40th anniversary of the Aga Khan University, we draw inspiration from the vision of our founder and the story of its realization through the decades. The Aga Khan University was a project of unprecedented ambition in the Pakistan of the 1960s and 70s. We recall the many questions and countless challenges our planners faced in the early days. How to ensure the curriculum prepared graduates for world-class practice and for local needs. How to enable access for people from all walks of life. But individuals and institutions around the world were drawn to the Chancellor's vision. With their support, AKU was able to begin its amazing journey.
Many people from many walks of life have contributed to this achievement, including the donors from whom there has been a massive response.
Our first campus site stood far from Karachi's city center, looking barren, dusty, and remote. But our founder saw its potential. A key initial step was the creation of an architectural idiom for the first campus that incorporated traditional Islamic art forms for contemporary use. The design would be timeless and eventually tie together the identity of our campuses internationally. Driven by audacious ambition, we received our charter from the government of Pakistan, making us the first private university in the country. This milestone unlocked a huge potential for AKU to make an impact in multiple areas, and the Chancellor made sure that we stay true to our mission.
And the university must be able to adapt itself to change. But one thing will remain constant: the mission of preparing graduates, men and women, to play constructive, worthwhile, and responsible roles in society.
40 years ago, starting with only one diploma program, we nurture 39 changemakers in only one country. Today, 16,000 is not just the number of graduates that AKU has produced. It also reflects the number of leaders it has empowered in diverse disciplines on campuses in six countries across three continents. With 86% of AKU students receiving financial assistance and 2 in 3 students being women, AKU is living true to the founder's vision. AKU enables thousands to avail world-class education and empowers women with opportunities that transform their lives and that of their families. More than 12,000 of our graduates are women. Our graduates can be found in leadership positions from Karachi to Kabul, from Nairobi to New York, from Great Britain to British Columbia. And at home, on our campuses, we see more and more of our graduates in key leadership positions, providing the intellectual prowess and growing AKU's breadth and impact. Today, AKU is a powerful source of opportunity, insight, and healing. With campuses, hospitals, students, and faculty in Pakistan, Kenya, Tanzania, Uganda, the United Kingdom, and Afghanistan, AKU has fulfilled yet another element of the founder's vision, that is, to capitalize on our diversity and resources and become a truly international university with impact across borders.
Let me emphasize that we see these various units as integrated parts of one university, working closely together across academic disciplines, across nations, and across continents in our increasingly borderless world.
Today, AKU has 7 hospitals and 350 outreach centers across Pakistan, Afghanistan, and East Africa that have received international accreditation. These facilities provide high-quality care to more than 2 million patients every year through a robust patient welfare program. Last year alone, our hospitals provided $28 million in welfare to help patients receive care at its facilities. AKU aims to serve societies and build capacities in urban and rural areas alike to enable more communities to get back on their feet and empower healthcare workers to deliver life-saving care, especially in times of crises. Having established a strong foundation in health sciences education and service, we have ventured well beyond with programs focusing on the study of Muslim civilizations, journalism and communications, examination systems and quality of learning, early childhood education and education systems, simulation learning, nutrition, agriculture and environmental stewardship, mental health and well-being, and more. In our pursuit of excellence, researchers at AKU continue to develop innovative solutions to long-standing issues faced in the regions where we operate. Knowledge generated by research at AKU contributes to policy making, helping us advance a step closer to achieving the Sustainable Development Goals and fostering a culture of innovation in a world of increasing complexities. As we enter our 40th year, a new AKU is taking shape. New academic programs are being launched. New facilities are rising. Long-standing ambitions are being fulfilled. Looking to the past, we draw confidence for the future. Recommitting to the vision of our founder, we equip ourselves for the journey ahead.
Our goals were ambitious, after all, back in 1983. And yet, if we could have glimpsed into the future then, if we could have forecast what this day would look like, I think we would have been very happy with the way the story has unfolded. And so it is that we see ourselves today in the context of a rich historical tradition and a recent past filled with genuine achievement. For that, I want to express again to all of you the deep sense of joy and gratitude that I feel as I join you for this celebration and as we look together to our challenging, promising future. Thank you.